If you're making these three Canva Teams mistakes, it's time to turn it around. I'm Donna Moritz, Canva Verified Expert, and I get to train teams of 1 to 1,000 plus to create on-brand visual content. But it also means I get to see my fair share of mistakes that teams are making, which is the reason for this video. I'll share three Canva Teams mistakes and how to fix them, and stick around to the end for a bonus tip to really help your team's workflow. For the purposes of demonstration today, I'm going to use a fictional company, Grow Wealth Management, to demonstrate how to create on-brand content quickly at scale with Canva Teams by avoiding these three key mistakes. Now, I'm guessing you're here because you are familiar with or interested in Canva Teams. It's an awesome solution for teams big and small that lets you enhance productivity, collaborate in real time, and communicate visually with everything from docs to presentations to whiteboards to branded templates. It takes all the features you get in Canva Pro, so millions of visual and audio elements, templates, fonts, and all the AI magic design features, but goes to the next level in terms of the ability to create visual content and organize, save, share, and approve that content as a team. Okay, let's jump in to the three big mistakes to avoid. Mistake number one is not leveraging your brand kit. Now, most people that have Canva Pro or Canva Teams do understand that you can set up a brand kit. Step one is setting it up, but step two is leveraging it and making sure you get the most out of it. Let me show you what I mean. Canva Teams is more than just adding a brand kit. In fact, it's not just enough to add your logos, your colors, and your fonts, but you should also be adding your entire brand identity. So that includes things like adding your brand voice so it can be pulled in by Magic Write if you're using the AI writing tool, adding approved photos so that your team can instantly grab assets that they know they can use, and things like graphics, headshots, icons, illustrations that are approved for your brand. Mistake number two is not using brand templates as a team. On one hand, we have the designer over here getting frustrated because maybe the team's going a bit rogue with brand assets and not sticking to brand guidelines. And on the other hand, we have the non-designers on the team getting frustrated because they have more important work to do than to learn how to design. When you use brand templates, everyone is happy, the designers and the non-designers. Let's take a look at some brand templates. If you come in to your brand templates, you can see here I've added a number of brand templates for Grow Wealth Management, and brand templates save you so much time. Your non-designers on the team can come in and easily take a look at a template and decide to apply it to their account. They're actually making a copy of the original, so nobody's breaking the original template. They get their own version to play with, and you can have so many different assets ready to go for the non-designers on your team. This means that the designer is happy because their designs are not going to get wrecked easily, and the non-designers are happy because they have ready-to-go templates that they can use really easily. You can see here there's a whole range of templates here, from static images to videos. In this case, if I was a member of the team and I wanted to just come in and edit this video quickly, I can easily drag and drop one of the brand graphics or images or approved photos we have ready to go. It's that easy. Now, just because you have brand templates does not mean they are foolproof. So an extra step you can take is to avoid the mistake of not using brand locking. Let's take a look at how this works. Let's demo with this brand template. Now, I designed the template, so in my account, I have access to this menu to edit the original brand template. But I just want to show you that despite it being nicely designed, it's not perfect because someone could literally move around all the elements, and I don't really want that to make it easy to edit. So what we want to do is go up to this page icon here for locking, and I'm going to set only allow replacing content. This means that the non-designers in my team can easily switch out images and text, but not all the elements and colors, etc. I just want it to be easy for them to edit. And because we're in Canva Teams, it's easy for my team member to choose a brand template and then click use this brand template. So they're essentially making a copy of the original. They're not editing my original. And as you can see, they can't move things around. It's very hyper-focused so that they can just change out the image and the text and keep the colors and even the fonts in place. So they can click on the image and then go to Elements, choose a new image and drag it in. It's that easy. And of course, everything is ready to go for them to change out the text using the brand fonts. Now you might say, Donna, that seems a bit extreme to lock down a template quite that much. And yes, you can lock it down like that if you've got team members that just really want to come in and do quick changes, but you can get more granular with your locking as well. So using this video template, this is just a template for an ad that maybe the team members could use for all sorts of content. I want to give them a little bit more control. So I'm going to lock down the things that really don't need to be moved because they're part of the design layout. So we're going to lock down the logo here because they don't really need to edit that at all. And I'm going to then use lock position only for other elements. So here I'm going to click on this frame for the photo, and I don't really want that to move because it's right where it needs to be. So we're going to right click, lock, and then go position only. So I'm not locking it fully. I'm just locking it from moving it around, and they can still drag in the photos. And up here on the text, again, I can lock and position only because I want them to be able to change the text, even edit the colors, but not move it in position. And so usually in training, I will do things like talk to non-designers about trying to keep the text the same size or length and just sort of keep within the spirit of the original design. But hopefully that shows you that there are layers of locking. You don't have to go extreme. It just really depends on your team and what their needs are and how experienced they are with editing templates. And hot tip, I always say to my clients using Canva Teams that they should leverage the brand kit for adding approved brand photography. That way team members know that they can come in and use these photos, add them straight to templates, and they're good to go. And a cool feature of Canva Teams is that you can use brand controls. So certain members of the team can have admin capability to lock down things like color and fonts so that team members can only use approved brand colors or brand fonts. And you can also set it so that they have to get design approval before sharing or publishing templates. So all of this helps keep everyone on track to create on-brand content at scale and really helps boost the productivity of your team. Let's recap. Mistake number one is not leveraging your brand kit to its full potential. There's so much you can do beyond adding a logo and some colors. Mistake number two is not using brand templates. So when the designer works with non-designers with brand templates, everyone can create amazing visual content that's on brand and at scale. And mistake number three is not using brand locking, so template locking and brand protections. This allows everyone to create content without having to think too much or go back to being a designer. And I promised a bonus mistake, and this is all about not using collaboration tools in Canva. You should absolutely use them. I see so many teams that are focusing on the visual content creation. They don't realize just how powerful Canva is and some of the amazing productivity and workflow tools available. I'd even go so far to say that if you use some of these collaboration tools for communication as a team, it could mean death to email or at least significantly reduce it and other tools like Slack. Let me show you just a couple of things you can use as a team. Let's start with a small but mighty functionality that saves so much time. It's comments and approvals in Canva. I see so many teams not leveraging this and they're over in email when they don't need to be. You can communicate with your team or even invite in other people like clients into projects and communicate right where you do your work. So it's simply a matter of tagging, say in Canva Teams, set tagging a team member, starting a comment thread, then you can add replies. You can also add stickers and emojis and things like that as well. Now, the cool thing is in Canva Teams, you can also do approvals in this way so that the non-designers in your team can quickly get approval for the work that they're doing and go ahead and schedule it and post it and publish it. And without going down a rabbit hole, I just want to mention the ecosystem that's in Canva for amazing productivity and workflow using a whole interplay of documents. So from whiteboards to Canva Docs to presentations, your team can save so much time. I want to highlight whiteboards because they are just a really cool way of collaborating on projects. I don't even want to call them meetings. It's way more fun than that. You can set timers, have everyone go away and brainstorm on something, add their virtual ideas via sticky notes. And then in a new feature that Canva has released, you know, they can add reactions. And also then you can, in one click, summarize that information into colors, names, reactions, or topics so that it's easily deciphered. And using Canva's magic AI, you can also, in one click, turn a whiteboard into a Canva doc to summarize all of the information. And in another click, you can turn it into a presentation. The other fun thing is that Magic Write, Canva's AI writing tool, is embedded throughout all of this. So if you need to just generate some quick ideas using AI, or you want to perhaps, do some prompts for social media posts, you can jump in and do that. Now, Canva's AI Magic Write has had a few upgrades too, and now you can add prompts and then do iterations. So we'll iterate on previous prompts. It can do things like spell checks and summarize. There's so many different things you can do with Magic Write. So just be aware that as a team, this is all embedded in Canva Teams. To find out more about Canva Teams, use the link on the screen, or I'll add a link to the description below, along with a link to the pricing for both Teams and Canva Pro. You need a minimum of 3 people to move on to Teams, so see what works best for your business. And if you have any questions about Canva Teams, be sure to hit me up in the comments. Hopefully it's happy days leveraging Canva Teams for your non-designer team members, to your designer, to your manager. And for me, as a Canva verified expert and a Canva creator of templates for Canva's library, I've had over 23 million of my templates used by Canva users. One of my happy places is training teams and branded templates. So if you're looking to get your team's ducks in a row in terms of brand kit, brand templates, brand controls, and team collaboration, then definitely get in touch. I love nothing more than helping teams to be empowered to create on-brand content. If you like this video, please subscribe. It helps me to create more content for you. Let me know what your favorite Canva Teams feature is, and check out the video on the screen for more Canva tips for your team. That's it from me. Stay creative.